Hello, good evening. My name is Janus de la Cruz, and now I'm taking over Art Blast Magazine's Instagram page. So take over na siya. Before we start, I would like to introduce myself. So my name is Janus de la Cruz. My real name is John Olympus Salvador P. de la Cruz. So the Olympus is the O, S is yung Salvador is the S. So when they combined it together, it became Janus. So it's one of those things that works na something interesting for me. That I have a very long name. I'm a Filipino artist. I am a painter, a printmaker, and a sculptor. I studied at the University of Santo Tomas, graduate of fine arts. And the best thing to say about myself is that I am a storyteller. I consider painting or printmaking or sculpture as something, as a way to tell a story. Because when I was younger, I had a very vivid imagination, and my imagination always carried me to different fantasies, different places. That's something awkward. I've always been an awkward little child. Something na a lot of people can relate to is I grew up in a household of artists. My father is also an artist. So my earliest memory is actually when I was 5 years old. I was sitting on the lap of my father, and yung pinakauna kong memories, literally nagsascratch ako, I actually damaged one of his artworks. So yun yung first memory ko na I wanted to create something. I wanted to either destroy or from something na existing, create something different. I've always considered myself someone who doesn't want to conform. And to describe myself is very awkward because before I tell you ano yung artwork ko, I have to tell you some basic facts about me. My father is Bulaqueño, my mother is Ilongga, and I was born in Cotabato. So sa Pilipinas, yung Luzon, ang hometown, wala akong hometown. Sa Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao ako. So pag tinanong niyo ako, anong artist ka? Bulaqueño artist ka ba? Ilonggo artist ka ba? Or Magindanawan ka ba? Honestly, ako personally, I find it really awkward kasi it nabibigyan na pag nagsasabi ako sa mga tao kung anong klaseng taga saan ako, sa anong probinsya ko, hometown ko, hindi ko masabi specifically kasi I grew up near Bulacan. So, syempre, lagi ako nauuwi doon. Pero, pag kunwari, dumadalo naman ako sa mga relatives ko before sa Visayas, lagi naman ako nauuwi din ako sa Iloilo. Pero, syempre, may mga relatives din ako sa Mindanao. So, lagi din ako nasa Mindanao. Ang nakakatawa dito, I can't really put myself in a certain regional group. Kasi, every region is my hometown. Parang ganun. Before we start the Q&A, I'm going to answer certain questions that provided for me. Then from those questions, I'll try to expand and tell you the story and philosophy behind my work. So first question, what keeps you busy during quarantine and how are you doing? I'm actually doing fine. I think tawag dito, that's yung misnomer ng mga public, ng mga tao about the quarantine it has to be something very morbid, something that is very dark, or something that is very pessimistic. Pero as an artist, if the quarantine is you are locked in your house and hindi ka makalabas ng bahay, yun naman din ang talaga ginagawa ng mga artist. We don't really go outside. We paint all the time. If you are a serious painter, the only time you actually go out or have a life is when you go to exhibitions, when you buy art materials, or when you go somewhere to do an art project, and happenstance may dumating na, uy, kakilala mo. Yun lang. And we really don't, artists don't have social lives. And when people ask me kung ano ginagawa ko sa bahay ko, most of the time, honestly, I work 18 hours a day. The reason I say 18 hours a day because I also include yung tulog ko sa work ko. And I'll expand on that later. I work 18 hours a day. I wake up at around 7 o'clock in the morning. I sleep at around 2 a.m. And that's my life. That's I work all the time. So what's the difference between quarantine and just staying at home and working? Actually, the nice thing about the quarantine is nobody asks you to go anywhere. Nobody invites you to anywhere. So basically, all you have so much time to just work. And honestly, that's the one thing that I enjoy about my job. I love working. I love creating. I love trying to express myself through my art. So I'll expand on that later. How has the pandemic affected you as an artist? Actually, the pandemic, besides the not being able to go outside, not being able to see friends, see loved ones, or being able to at least unwind, the lockdown was actually a blessing in disguise for artists. Besides the fact na medyo mahirap lang talaga, mahirap lang ngayon na to make a living or mingle with friends or meet clients or see yung mga works of other artists, the pandemic actually gave artists the opportunity to soul search and to find their own voice. And in a weird way, I am thankful that I had the opportunity to work. Pero at the same time, I'm a little bit apprehensive and a little bit scared. In a way, if this continues on and on and on, I don't want the year 2020, especially when they talk about art in the 2020, to be described like a long nightmare. So, because artists are storytellers, we are the modern day oral historians. When history and when people read about other cultures and civilization, they always look at yung kung ano yung mga cultural artifacts that civilization left behind. And we as artists, we showcase what is the current mood and the current ideas of the society. And personally, I find it a little bit disheartening and pessimistic. If this entire year, we will devote yung mga artwork natin just describing this specific incident. Because I'm spiritual in nature and I'm a realist. This is a hard time for everyone. Pero this will also end. And sooner or later, we'll have in the darkest days, there will be a brightest day afterwards. Would you like to share some of the challenges that you are facing? Okay. Pinaka-challenge ko for this pandemic as an artist is not having the opportunity to buy materials. And I always talk with my other artist friends. They always tell me, "Ay, now dito I don't have canvas anymore. Oh, I don't have paint anymore. I don't have this and that." I remember a time na when nagkaubusan ng puti sa lahat ng art store because there was a custom thing and na-hold yung mga pintura. At that point in time, I didn't even realize ano ang value ng puti. Kasi, syempre parang na-underestimate mo lang pinta ka lang ng pinta. Pero literally, hindi ka makapinta ng anything pag walang puti. Doon mo lang ma-appreciate yung something so small. Then, pag nawala na, doon mo lang mapapansin yung ano yung true value niya. So, for me, tawag dito, ang pinaka-hardship ko ngayon is trying to save, to make sure na yung mga pintura, yung mga pintura ko, marami akong stock. And to be honest, I don't have that problem. Naman, I always stock up in my paints. There's this story that my dad once told me, and I want to share with you guys. Nung batang pintor yung tatay ko, he told me na pangarap niya magkaroon ng studio. And nung gumawa siya ng studio, pinangarap niya na pag kunwari nagpipinta siya, hindi siya maubusan ng stock. Gusto niya magkaroon ng isang studio na parang national bookstore, na literally bubunot-bunot lang siya ng pintura. And honestly, that is one thing that I have invited in my own art creation. Nagsa-stockpile ako. So, I'll show you ngayon yung pintura ko. Na honestly, hindi ako nabusan ng pintura kasi ang pera ko, like, ini-invest ko siya, ganito ang ginagawa ko eh. When I earn money, I save a certain amount for my self-savings, and the rest I invest in my art, I invest in myself. So pag gumagawa ako ng mga artwork, or gumagawa ako ng, pag may bumili ako sa art store, ito yung ginagawa ko. If you notice, ito yung easel ko. I'll show you mamaya yung studio, pero may easel is ito. Nakikita nyo lahat ito. Like literally, I have an entire cabinet of paint. I have an entire cabinet of paint. I have literally more paints here. And this is the fun part. I share a studio with my dad. So, he's also an artist. And the lucky thing about my situation is, my dad is currently in vacation in America. Well, technically he's in vacation kasi na-lockdown siya. So I actually have his studio is actually we share the same studio, so that's his easel. So yung easel niya is also full of paint. So literally kapag naubusan na ako ng pintura, makikinakaw na lang ako. So wala akong problema sa pintura. Canvas naman. Saktong-sakto before nagsimula tong pandemic, I was already planning to do a show. So literally pag 2 days before the start of the lockdown, dumating yung delivery ko ng canvas. So I had like 20 canvases. So I was lucky. So honestly, the COVID thing didn't really affect me. I think the most affected thing that happened to me this COVID time is because most of the time I live alone. So literally, I've been stuck in this house for 4 months alone. Like my dad left in February. I've been alone from February up until now. So like 4 months mag-isa ako. So yun ang actually ang struggle ko is the isolation. Okay. Next question. What do you think is the role of art in this pandemic situation? I think the role of the artist, like in any situation, is we are the tellers of truth. Na society, we write history. We define how the world sees that specific point in generation. So whatever we paint, it is something that you have to respect. Something that you try to tell something that is truthful, something that is in your heart. So ako, pag ako nagpipaint ako, especially during this time, ang process ko is always been, I always paint kung ano yung totoo sa akin. When I say totoo sa akin, kasi it's a generational thing eh. Yung, pag kunwari, you were born, in my generation of artists, is we had the privilege na art is already considered as a viable profession. that anything can be an artwork. You don't have to have a formal education. You don't have to have be trained in classical art forms. Basically, all you need sometimes is just a piece of computer and an imagination or an idea. And you don't even have to create your own sculpture. You can have it made by somebody else. Pero ako kasi as an artist, I always, ano ako, traditionalist ako eh. I don't like producing artworks that I did not actually create myself. So, for me, ang role of art during this pandemic is we have to describe, we have to ipakita kung ano yung nararamdaman natin at saka kung ano yung nakikita natin sa ating society. Anyway, that's the best answer I can give. Sixth question. What do you foresee will be the impact of COVID-19 in the future of the art scene? That's actually a very good question. I think the impact of COVID-19 is nagkaroon ng democratization in art. Because before, to be able to showcase your work, you have to be part of a gallery. You have to be part of an institution. You have to showcase your work in a 4x4 structure, the formal setting na may mga nakasabit artwork, may mga cocktail, ganun. Ngayon, the artists became more creative, and when they became more creative, nauso yung virtual exhibitions. Pero for me, I'm not really a big fan of virtual exhibitions. The reason for that is, there's a big difference between seeing a picture in a phone and seeing an actual artwork. There's a big difference between a 2x2 painting and a 4x6 painting. And it is something na if you just see it on a phone, walang impact siya kasi it's all the same sizes. And it's disheartening na ngayon because of the hindi ka makalabas ng bahay, they have to showcase the work online, na yun lang yung only way to showcase artwork, na hindi ma-appreciate yung scale and scope of the artwork. Kasi me personally, I don't like creating small works. I like creating larger than life works. Kasi if you notice, I'm a big guy. Kapag kunwari nagpapapicture ako, katabi ng artwork ko, have you ever noticed na kapag kunwari may katabi kang painting, na kunwari 2x2, pag tinabihan ko yung painting ko, grabe, naliliit yung painting, yung malaki akong tao. So I have to create works that are plywood size or 6 feet by 4 feet so that when I stand beside the artwork, visually, nagiging proportional siya. So I have to create big works para pag pinicture na ako, hindi ako masyado mukhang mataba. So, so that's why I love big works. And actually, I prefer big artworks kasi I don't like the idea of collecting artwork for the sake of collecting artwork. Like when you buy an artwork, then because, oh my God, you have an artwork of this and that. Tapos mangyayari dyan, yung artwork ngayon, lalagay mo sa CR o itatago mo sa storage mo somewhere na nakatago lang. Basically, nangolekta ng artwork mo is alikabok. Ako, I like creating big artworks, larger than life. The reason for that is, paano mo itatago yung ganito kalaking painting sa bodega? So literally, kapag pumili ka na ganito, but if you get a painting this big, you have to put it on a wall. Kasi me, as an artist, I don't like the concept of I like interacting with my viewer. I like interacting with my client. I like when I create an artwork, each artwork is not a cookie cut na design na pare-pareho lang or may pare-parehong theme. I want each artwork to have a soul. So literally when I create an artwork, I want to be offended. I want to be praised. I want to be offended to the point, I don't like your artwork. I want to know why. Kasi you put your soul in a piece of painting. Kasi if you create an artwork just for the sake of collecting or for the sake of decoration, that's not me eh. Kasi I always envision myself as someone who likes to impart stories. So each artwork for me, each of my paintings, tell a certain story. Some of them are autobiographical, some of them I've seen, or some of them I learned along the way. But each painting has a soul. I believe that paintings are like orphans. Na each painting has a parent. It just so happens to be kailan makukuha yon ng proper parents niya. So I think every painting has it. Basically, every painting is a bastard. Alam mo yun, meron niya ng sariling magulang. Hahanapin mo lang. Okay. What is the next question? How about its impact on visual artists and art making? Yung sa COVID-19. Actually, tawag dito. I'm not really a very sociable person, so I can only talk to about myself. But personally, after this COVID, when they opened the quarantine, I'll probably stay another month here sa bahay, just working. Kasi I think the only naging problem ko during this COVID time is pahirapan sa pagkain, and you know, man, I'm very antisocial, so it's easier for me. I don't have to go outside, I don't have to talk to people. So lucky for me, I guess I can just work. Ang pinaka problem lang dito talaga is the materials. There are some things that we as artists, like ako, this is one thing na naturo sa akin eh. Pag kunwari wala ka ng canvas, edi maghanap ka ng papel. Pag wala ka ng papel, edi mag-drawing ka sa pader. Alam mo yun, like, you don't have to stop creating just because you don't have materials. You can always find materials to create your own work. How are you preparing for the post-pandemic future? Okay. Now, dito, I think I'm preparing kasi because the pandemic, it removed the importance of having a show, an actual exhibition. Now, it became more virtual or something that is online. I think as an artist, me personally, I'm preparing by having a social media presence. Because when I started painting about 15 years ago, I remember pupunta ako sa mga gallery, may dala-dala, I bring a portfolio. When I say portfolio, a clear book with a 5x7 photo of my painting. Then underneath is typewritten the title and this and that. Literally a clear book of my paintings. And when I showcase yung paintings ko, I go to the gallery. I don't know who the owner is. I don't know who's in charge. Then literally, my idea behind that is when I first started my career, this is what I did. I brought two clear books full of pictures of my painting with typewritten details. I was bringing those two clear books, and I actually bring one sample of my painting. I go to a gallery. Obviously, I don't know who the gallery manager is. I don't know who the owner is. What I assume is, I look for the farthest table from the entrance. Kung sino yung nasa table, yun ang kakausapin ko. Then I go into that person. Then I would do this. Hello sir, my name is Janos de la Cruz. Here is a sample of my work. Kinda like si Oliver. Please sir, give me more sir. Here's my artwork. Please sir, view niya siya. So actually I did that for, especially after college. Like, I think it's one of those lost art forms eh. Kasi ngayon, young artists tend to say na, oh, because I'm an artist, I'm great. Kailangan ma-exhibit ka agad ako. It is one of those things that dapat ginagawa ng mga bata ngayon. That they have to, that's a lost art form na nakalimutan nila. Yung to actually present your work consistently, not just post it online. Pero ngayon, because of social media, obviously, we have to post in Instagram, you have to post in Twitter, you have to post in Facebook. Ngayon, it's no longer enough just to post your artwork. Now, you also have to post a video. You have to post a video of you working. Alam mo yung ganun? You have to post a video of you exhibiting. You post a video of you painting something with music in the background. So, it's something, it's part of the promotion. So in this post-pandemic future, the gallery is no longer in charge of promoting, not just promoting the artist. It's also the responsibility of the artist to promote himself or herself. So that before, bibigay mo lang artwork mo sa gallery and the gallery will promote you. Ngayon, hindi na dapat ganun lang. Ngayon, as an artist, you have to promote yourself. You have to sell yourself. When you're selling yourself, I'm not talking about you're just selling yourself na binibenta mo in terms of pera. I'm talking about you as an artist selling a vision, an idea. Because when a viewer looks at an artwork, it's just a piece of cloth. It's just a piece of cloth na may kulay, or it's just a piece of paper na may ink. Pero bakit ganito ang intrinsic value niya? Bakit siya mahal? Actually, the viewer or the client is not buying the piece of cloth or the piece of paper. They are actually buying you as the artist. They are buying your future. The idea that when they purchase or they buy the artwork, they are helping you to move forward in your career. Every artwork that you create, every client that supports you, gives you an opportunity to create a new work and new work, so on and so forth. So in this post-pandemic future, promotion is important. So I think marami na mga artists ngayon na magiging active sa social media. And I really hope na hindi maging future ng Philippine art virtual exhibitions, kasi gagawa ka ng malaking painting tapos ipopost, tapos sa isang painting mo plywood size, tapos lalabas sa camera ganito kalaki yung picture. Parang gagawa nila kung ganito kalaki yung painting, pareho lang din naman, di ba? Okay. How would you like, may main question, do you think self-promotion affects the integrity of the work? There's nothing wrong with self-promotion as long as there is a clear vision behind the work. Kasi maraming pwede mo naman kasi sabihin, ay, yung artwork ko maganda, maganda, maganda. Pero there's always a point na dapat yung integrity of your work is very important, na kailangan na una muna ano yung idea mo behind the work. Hindi pwede puro angas lang. So, tapusin ko lang muna itong question na ito, then we'll go on the Q&A, promise. How would you like to remember these times? I would like to remember these times as a very challenging exercise. And thank God for Netflix. Thank God for Spotify. And thank God for Lazada and Shopee, because without those things, I think I'll go psycho 4 months. Kaya 3 months lang ako, 4 months na akong stuck in the house. Okay. Pero in all seriousness, I think this time will be remembered as a very important milestone in art. Kasi as an artist, like ngayon, recently, I was invited to participate in this charity auction. When they invited us, it is one of those things that I really appreciate, because before, when foundations or events invite artists, they always ask artists for 100% outright. When they say donate, like literally they want the artist to donate 100%. And before kasi it's okay, pero kasi in these times, especially when you ask an artist kasi to donate an artwork, you're not just asking to donate their talent, you're also asking them to donate their investment in their art. Kasi hindi naman yan painting yan. Bago yung naging painting, yung artist bumili ng kahoy, yung artist bumili ng papel, o yung artist bumili ng canvas, yung artist bumili ng pintura. So before nagawa yung ID, like ako personally, I like to donate my talent. Pero during this time, it's really hard to help other to donate outright. And to go back to my story, I like to remember this time because nung I joined this foundation when that they wanted to help the less fortunate, the organizer told us that a portion of the proceeds will go to a pool, a collection pool, and yung money na would be collected, the part of the money that mapupunta doon sa pool na yun will be distributed equally with the artist. And I found it refreshing because before, people tend to abuse artists. Basically, kahit nagsimula ito nung college or high school, pag ikaw nakita nila, especially pag bata ka, pag high school student ka, nakita nila nag-drawing ka, ano sinasabi usually? Uy, ang galing mo mag-drawing. Drawing mo nga ako. So basically, may misnomer ang viewing public like the artwork is free. You know what I mean? Like, from a young age, from grade school to high school to college, they have this misnomer that you can just ask and ask for free stuff. So for me, as an artist, it's about time that yes, we will help other people, but of course we have to also help ourselves, especially during this time. Yung mga pa-drawing, correct, ayun. Yung mga pa-drawing, pag kunwari grade school ka, may magpapa-drawing. Pag high school ka, may magpapa-drawing. Pagdating mo ng college, may magpapagawa ng play. Pati ba naman ngayon, na professional artist na tayo, meron pa rin pahingi, di ba? Come on, like, you have the capability to help other people. You want to help other people, pero pagdating sa artist, gusto nyo hingi, di ba? Parang mahirap pa tayo. Like, ganito na lang. If kunwari, gusto nyo humingi sa akin, bigyan nyo ako ng canvas, bigyan nyo sa akin ng pintura nyo, ako magpipinta. Tapos babalik ko sa inyo. Ganun na lang. Dari-dari ako, pintura ko, canvas ko, tapos bibigay ko sa inyo. So, tawag dito. Sorry, meron nag-try mag-video chat eh. Sorry. Anyway. Is there any message or advice that you would like to share with the art community and public? I think the one that I would like to share to the public is artists sa art community, we are the lucky few. We are able to create our work. We are able to express ourselves. And we are lucky kasi we are able to do the things that we love. And for me, we are privileged. And I personally, I think it is, I like to thank God for that. And I hope na pag after this COVID season, it gets back to normal. Because right now, it's really hard. It's really hard na to be stuck in one place, just being alone. And at the same time, it's also hard to find ideas that are less depressive. Kung puro na lang naririnig natin in the media, is puro nakakalungkot, laging gulo, laging puro sakit, ganun. So it's much better just to work na lang. Pero anyway, so ano, yun, nasagot ko na yung 10 questions about na binigay sa akin. So, if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. Pero, I would like to talk about muna yung process ko. Pero pag may have any questions, I would answer it. Pag gumagawa ako ng artwork, when I create an artwork, it is a three process for me. It's four stages. The first stage is dreaming. Because ako, since I was young, I've always had a very vivid imagination. And when I see, I always have this cold sweat dreams every night. So what I do is I I put a piece of my sketch pad right beside me when I sleep. So pag when I wake up, alam mo yung pagkunwari na nag-init ka when you dream and you wake up, you remember the emotion vividly for a split second. In that split second, you think it's true. Pero then, after a while, you forget what you dream of. So what I do is when I wake up and I have a dream, I have a notebook right beside me, then I doodle it. I try to catch it. I try to capture it. So I have a lot of notebooks. Mga notebooks of doodles. And from those doodles, I transform them into artworks. So from doodles, where do you find your inspiration? One of the things that I find inspiration from is actually real life. I always say that my artwork is an extension of myself. And most of my paintings is autobiographical. And it's autobiographical in a way that I always have a hero figure or a messianic figure in the middle or a main figure, and he is interacting or he is showing emotion or capturing or finding his surroundings awkwardly. I draw. Then from those doodles, obviously it's just a doodle, like it's just a rambling of lines. And from those lines, I try to interpret it in a final drawing. So I draw more concisely. I always have each painting has a specific drawing. So basically, one idea, I always create a lot of artworks from that single idea. So from a doodle, I transform it into a pen and ink. From that pen and ink, I reinterpret it into an etching, a fine print. Then from that fine print, I transform it into a painting. Or sometimes, I start from a drawing, then I go to a painting, then from a painting, I transform it into a print. Kasi for me, as an artist, is about constant transformation. Me as an artist, I believe that from a single idea you can develop different thoughts or different emotions. Like for example, if I started a drawing where I'm in love, but the concept is the same concept, but the application or the design different. It becomes a little bit more colorful. It becomes more soft. It becomes more poignant. So, with a single idea, you can create different artworks. So that's what I do. I create an artwork, one concept, then from a doodle to a drawing to a fine print to a painting, and sometimes I mishmash like that. What advice can you give to those beginners to be a painter artist? Actually, that's a very good question. When I was teaching in UST, that is a question that I always pondered in, and I always love answering. The best advice I can give is very simple. This is something that I learned working here in the studio with my dad. Because when I graduated college, I had this mindset na, I will only paint when I am inspired. I need to be inspired to work. You know, I have to have a great idea to work, you know. The one thing that I learned from my dad is if you paint only when you are inspired, then you will grow hungry. Because you have to treat art seriously. You have to treat it like a profession. Because if you only paint when you are happy, or you paint when you are only inspired, you are just wasting your time. Sometimes the best inspiration is depression. Sometimes the best inspiration is problems at home or problems or whatever, or having a good time. You have to find inspiration from different sources, not just when you just feel happy when you want to paint. Basically, you have to treat it like a job. You have to wake up early. You have to paint all the time. Don't waste your time na drawing lang. or tawag dito, you have to put it in canvas, you have to paint it. You don't waste your time waiting for inspiration. You have to treat it like a job. Sometimes it hurts. Sometimes when I paint, it hurts. Kasi you're not happy, you're not inspired, but you have to create. Kasi for me, art is my addiction. It is something that I love. Pero at the same time, there are moments that I feel that art doesn't love me back. Pero it's like I'm like the parang kamsawi. Like it's like a gentle lover, you know. I love this. My mistress is art, but I am a jilted lover. I try to capture it, but it gets away, you know. So you have to work. Even if you don't feel like working, you have to work. This is something that I learned a long time ago. I'm so sorry if I always tell you stories about me and my dad, you know, because as an artist, we work in the same studio. So I work in this specific area. You're looking at me right now. This is my spot. But if you move the camera right here, that's where my dad works. So literally, we work side by side. We work side by side. So sometimes when I'm painting, he would move his rolling chair beside me, and he would just watch me paint and just talk, you know, just work and talk. And me, sometimes when I'm tired, I would move my chair on the side, go to his side, and talk to him. And it's very interesting because we are two different people. Because he grew up in a generation when we have different taste in music. Our artworks is different. Pero I learn a lot from him, and I hope he learns a lot from me also. Sometimes my artwork is affected by the types of music that we do. Kasi before, when I work, I always listen to Megadeth, Metallica, hard rock ako eh. I love rock music. But the problem is our Marilyn Manson, I love bass. I love Kiss, yung the band Kiss. But he can't appreciate it. He likes music like he likes Beatles, Matt Monroe, Engelbert Humperdinck, you know, stuff like that. And we have a stereo, and we fight over which music we would listen to. So for me, we had to compromise. So now we are listening to music that we both. Hello. Ah, yun. Okay. So we have to work. So we listen to music like we have to listen to music that we both have to agree on. So now, if he works here and I work here at the same time, most of the time we're probably listening to Ed Sheeran or kaya Ed Sheeran and Adele. Anyway, how would you describe your artwork? Okay, my artwork is a representation of who I am. I was born in 1985. I grew up in a generation when I was younger that you got home from school at 3 o'clock. When you got home from school, you play outside. Play until around 7 o'clock. Until your mom shout, well, like, at 7 o'clock, all the moms in the area would shout na umuwi na kayo, kakain na. I believe that my generation of children, the generation Y, is the last two children. Because after my generation, the millennials and generation Z, they don't have a childhood. They never got to play outside. They were preoccupied. They already had the ability to have cell phones, apps, games. They didn't have to interact with children. All they had to do was chat, you know. So basically, artwork ko, if I have to best describe it, is it's an adult trying to find innocence and trying to capture his lost youth amidst the reality na you are already old. So basically, parang yung artwork is balik childhood. Parang ganun. Ayan. Hi, kung hindi pa to natatanong, what's your usual routine and how did the pandemic affected your creative process? I think I answered that question, pero long story short, my usual routine is I wake up at 7, I work all day, then I sleep at around 2 a.m., then so on and so forth. I think ang naiba lang sa akin ngayon is mas tawag dito, hindi ako maka-attend sa mga exhibit. Yun lang, to be honest. Okay, tapos ito. So anyway, our house kasi it's called Bahay Singing. I share this house with my dad. The objective of Bahay Singing is we hope this would be an art atelier and to open it to other visual artists to promote the beautiful and very beautiful and very meticulous technique of printmaking. Because actually, as a visual artist, I don't consider myself just a painter. I'm also a printmaker. Actually, I'm a printmaker by heart. It is my first love, my first passion. For me, printmaking is a combination of skill, craftsmanship, and at the same time, patience. You have to be patient when you create prints. I'll show you, mamaya ikot ko sa inyo yung house. May mga samples ako papakita, don't worry. Anyway, tawag dito, the one thing, when I'm working, this is the one of the biggest lessons I learned when I do my work. What advice can you say, sir, to those beginners that are scared to show their art because they are scared of judgment that their works are not that good? Thank you, sir. Okay, I'll answer that question. I can give three pieces of advice. Not the advice, pero three ideas that all artists who wants to create great art follow. First, you have to have an attitude of an apprentice. When I say attitude of an apprentice is dapat hindi ka maangas. Don't think that you know everything. You have to have a very inquisitive mind. You have to always strive to learn something new. You don't judge people, especially any other artist, young or old, you should show them respect. Kasi you might learn something. When you have an attitude of an apprentice, you are always willing to learn. Kasi if you have an attitude of a master, what's the point of, bakit mo pa ako kailangan turuan eh, alam ko na lahat eh. Alam mo na pala lahat eh, bakit ka pa nagtatanong sa akin? You have to have an attitude na you are dapat nangungupo ka. Kailangan lagi may attitude ka na meron ka dapat laging natututo, dapat lagi kang willing matuto. Second, you have to have a hand of a craftsman. When I say you have to have a hand of a craftsman, is you have a great idea. You have a great idea. Pero hindi mo naman kaya gawin. Like, literally, ito yung nagiging point of contention ng mga ibang artist eh. Like, yung paborito nila, si Damien Hirst. I'm not trying to offend Damien Hirst or I know a couple of names, but I don't want to mention the other names. The problem kasi is like, you have a great idea, pero you can't implement it yourself. So, basically, art is supposed to be, it's like, art kasi is like you're God eh. You're creating something out of nothing eh. Alam mo yun? Why let other people do something when you can do it yourself? And the problem is, kapag kung nari pinagawa mo sa ibang tao, honestly, magkaiba naman yung idea ng tao na yun saka sa'yo. So, kahit nasabihin mo na in-approve mo yun, hindi naman yun yung gawa mo eh. Hindi naman yun yung literally yung vision mo eh. So, pag pinagawa mo sa trabaho mo sa ibang tao, it's just a reproduction. So it's better to create something from your own hands. So hands of a craftsman, you have to have the skill. And the most important attitude or idea for a complete artist is,
you know what you know and you don't know what you don't know, a learning experience.
And third and most important idea of an artist is you have to have a mind of a philosopher. And I say you have to have a mind of a philosopher. Okay, when I say that, ibig sabihin nun is you create artwork that tells your, that has an idea, that has a soul, that is meaningful. Now you don't create anything just for art's sake or art for mere decoration. Kasi every artwork is not meant just to be a decoration or something na isasabit sa wall. It's meant to have a statement. It's meant to express an emotion, to express a viewpoint. And that is yung usually nagiging problem, especially ng mga nagsisimula sa art scene, is they tend to follow trends. Na even na they have great skills, they are willing to learn, pero they don't have anything to say. What they do is just they Google it, then kung ano yung uso, they replicate it. And that's sad eh. Kasi when you ask them, ano ibig sabihin ng work mo? Sasabihin nila eh, kasi bakit yun yung kulay na pinili mo eh? Kasi yan yung, kasi pabenta yung pula eh. Kasi yan yung gusto ng Chinese kasi kulpula yung sikat eh. Or bakit mo ginawa yan? Eh kasi yan yung uso ngayon eh. Yung ganun. Or anong meaning mo behind your work? Tapos yung mga ibang tao lalagyan ng meaning. Tapos yung artist rin, yan yung uso eh. So parang, dapat you have to have an attitude of a philosopher. May moments ba na pinapakilaman ng dad mo ang process mo? Actually, tama dito. Ay, magdatarayan. Ano na makatama? Tama dito. Nung bata ako, syempre, bata eh. Alam mo yung, syempre, ang ganda to ha. Pero alam mo, pag ang ganda dyan is, yung ipaglalagay mo ito ng ganito. Yung alam mo yung papahiray niyo yung canvas mo. Nung bata ka, okay lang eh. Pero nung pagkunwari, pagdating mo ng high school or college, parang, canvas ka pero magpakailaman yung canvas ko. So minsan, nagkakatawa nung kami. Alam mo, nagkakatitigan na lang kami ganun. Tapos dito, ayaw mo lagyan ng ganito. Sasabihin ko, syempre, yun ko, iba idea ko yun eh. Pero maya-maya, mga siguro tutulugan ko. The following day, gagawin ko din naman. Kasi, ito yung idea na yun eh. Gusto kong gayahin yun eh. Tapos ganun din siya minsan. Pagkunwari, gagawa ko ng painting. Sasabihin ko, ay, tawag dito, ganda sana kung may ganito ganyan eh. I think ang art is for us is, hindi sa pinapakailaman yung artwork. It's more of a collaboration. Wait, anong oras na ba? Wait, wala pa. So it's more of a collaboration. Sir, if art is everything that occupies space and it has mass and weight, matters most, you know? Everything. If art is everything that occupies space and it has mass and weight, what matters most? Medyo may, hindi ko alam sagutin yung tanong na yan. Medyo malalim masyado para sa akin. Anyway, malapit ako matapos, so papakita ko nilang quick overview ng trabaho ko. Okay? Anyway, ito yung trabaho ko. So anyway, this is the etching press. Okay? This is the etching press. Dito namin ginagawa yung mga works on paper namin. And this machine was actually designed by my dad. It was fabricated here in the Philippines. And this is a sample of an etching. This is a copper plate na in-etch ko. Then I draw it on a piece of copper. Then from that copper, pinabad ko in acid. Then from that acid, this image came out. Ayun. So that is an etching. Okay, if you notice dito, marami akong mga nakatenggang artwork. So literally, pag gumagawa ako, nakapila, sunod-sunod, puro trabaho lang. Puro trabaho. Parang feeling ko tawag dito, it's already 6:56, so mukhang nakaisang oras na ako. So anyway, tawag dito, thank you very much. Napahaba yung conversation.
this is a sample of a rubber cut. So I carve a piece of rubber, then I put ink in it, then I print it. Then,
so if you have any other questions, hopefully magkaroon ng second Instagram takeover of Janas de la Cruz. So thank you very much Art Plus Magazine. Thank you. Love you guys. Stay safe. And please follow me at janasdelacruz.art. Love you guys. Stay safe. Bye-bye.